Hey y'all, I'm gonna be working in my fairy quotes journal again. I'm going to be trying to finish this up pretty soon so that I can start a design team project for Sunflowers Indoors. So I have a few things that I wanted to add. I wanted to add some little note sheets and things into the pockets as extra writing space. This is one that I wanted to put in here, but I'm gonna cut this down so that it fits in this pocket. These are rescued. I rescue all kinds of things from my local resale shops. Let's see if this is gonna fit. Notepad sheets are a great way to add fillers into your journals. You can just grab them out of there, make notes, journal on them, cut them up and use them for collage, watercolor on them. They're good for all kinds of things. You can write your information on them and hand them off to someone. So this fits in here now. Just a cute little addition. And then this one has some florals on it. It's blank on the back. I'm just gonna fold this in half. And put this in here. Very simple. This one, I just added in here. And then this one, I'm also going to cut down. And I'm gonna save this little sunflower part to use in a sunflower journal. I'm gonna take the perforated edge off. Slide this in here now. Okay. Here I decided I wanted to add another piece of ribbon across this quote, like I did in a previous video, a little bit further into the journal. So I'm just gonna take a pencil, mark where I need to cut my ribbon. Just gonna pull some threads off of the end here. And glue this down. And spread that glue out a little bit so it does not seep through the ribbon. And then it just adds a little something. And then this page is that ribbon tuck that I made. And I thought I was gonna put an envelope in here, but then I found this sheet that I had that says first think, second believe, third dream, and finally dare. And I'm gonna cut this down, but I also found this card in my stash And these are really cool cards. This child named Caitlin, she was 15. She's from Katy, Texas. This was a children's art project. You can pause to read. And then on the front, it has her name. And sadly, I think I'm going to have to cut that off, because I want to keep the information on the back. Now, it does still have her information here. I might not have to lose it. Let's see. I've got to cut this down to fit. So, let's see if I can cut it down but not lose her whole name. Oh, it's going to fit. Yay. Because of how I glued it. Let's see. Can I lift? It's pretty stuck. So let's see if I trim this side off a little bit. I have a whole bunch of these cards. These art cards made by children through that program. I'm determined this is going to fit. So I'm going to stretch the paper and pull that glue some. And if you just keep gently rubbing, it'll release. Yay! There we go. Super cute. I like the colors. The colors match up. So what I am going to do then is I'm going to cut this down to fit inside of this card. Okay. And this also is blank on the back so that it can be used for a journaling card. Oh, no, it is not on blank on the back. This came out of a book. So just some inspiration here. And then back here, I had said I wanted to add some things. I found this little purple envelope. I will be doing some stamping on another video in this journal. So I'll be putting a little bit of decoration on this purple envelope. And then I had some other note pad paper. And I'm just going to cut this advertisement off the top. And this will now fit inside of this envelope. And then I also added another floral note sheet to this pocket. And it just happens to have a purple outline around it. So some quick and simple things that you can do to add additional writing space into a journal. Thanks for watching, y'all.